Brigantia Blackbird of the Blackbird Grimoire. Welcome to the daily forecast for Friday, November 1st, 2024. It is the 11th of Scorpio and the day of the family. Now, as many of the longtime subscribers know, I have really gotten into associating particular days of the week with certain concepts or archetypes. And for the month of November, it's all going to be focused upon the family and the home. So hope you enjoy. And on that note, let's just dive right into this. We begin the month with a new moon, and in Scorpio, no less. And I found a couple of cheat sheets for us, as I like to. And for the Scorpio new moon, pursue what you find sexy, repurpose old goods into something new, embrace your alone time, read something esoteric, trust your intuition, hunt for treasures, even in your own closets, bake up more skin and bear more skin and soul. Well, maybe perhaps a bit more soul. You know, it's getting cold. It is November. So, you know, perhaps the skin doesn't need to be so bare. And then be mysterious, make people wonder. So we are starting off this month with a little bit of mischief and excitement and just a little bit of fun. And we've really been missing a lot of fun and a little bit of that sense of discovery and exploration and what's around the corner. And ooh, maybe it'll be something terribly exciting. We have been missing that for a long time. So I think the Scorpio new moon is a good opportunity to infuse a little bit about that, especially on today, since it is technically the first day of our spiritual new year. I also found a tarot spread for you. It is specifically for new moons in Scorpio, and you have a first card on one side that says, what rebirth would you like to see this new moon? And then best way to reconnect with your passions, and what ways have you been self-sabotaging? How can you be your own best cheerleader, and outcome of this new moon in Scorpio? So isn't this just perfect right now? It's allowing us an opportunity to reassess and to take the opportunity to discard some things that haven't really been working with us. To maybe alleviate some boredom that we felt that, you know, we just had to endure, reinfusing ourselves with a vitality and a zest for life. That's what this new moon in Scorpio can do for us. So I hope you are ready to rumble with your rituals tonight. Now for the details of our astrology, the sun is in Scorpio, fixed water, which is resourcefulness. The moon begins the day, fourth quarter Scorpio, fixed water, which represents brooding. And then at 7:47 a.m. Central Time, we do have that new moon, although, of course, I'm sure most of us are doing our rituals tonight. Then in Mercury, it is in Scorpio, fixed water, representing the spiritual. Venus is in Sagittarius, mutable water, representing generosity. Mars is in Cancer, cardinal water, which is seeking security. Jupiter is retrograding in Gemini, mutable air, which is to broaden perspectives. Saturn is retrograding in Pisces, mutable water, which is to redefine dreams. Uranus is retrograding in Taurus, fixed earth, representing rebellion. Neptune is retrograding in Pisces, mutable water, which is spiritual awakenings. And Pluto's in Capricorn, cardinal earth, representing reconstruction. Now for our retrograde reminders for Jupiter, reconnect with your true path, especially today. If there's anything about your spirituality over the past year that just hasn't quite fit, isn't where you need to be focused, or just really doesn't have anything to do with you, discard it. Make something better happen for you. Reconnect with where you really need to be. Somewhere in your soul, you know it. And even if you can't consciously articulate it, you will recognize it unconsciously when you start getting on the right path. So don't be afraid. Then for Saturn, reclaim your authority. You are in charge of your own life. And despite all of the people doing their best to tell you that you are not. So exercise that authority. Then for Uranus, reconsider how you rebel. We have nothing but rebellion around us right now, don't we? So giving that a rethink, because not all forms of rebellion are particularly effective. Not all of them actually advance the changes you would like to see. So learning to think more strategically is the main lesson of that. And then for Neptune, reclaim your magic. This is particularly important because even people who don't have much of a well of magical talent, or perhaps aren't aware of it, it's still a natural force that's in operation in the universe. It's still impacting us and affecting us, and we're always interacting with it in some way, form, or fashion. But for those of you within the craft, reclaiming your magic, that is really about, I think, reinvigorating your magical practices and remembering, you know, this isn't just a hobby. It isn't just something that you can do. You know, this is your calling in life. So pursue that calling. And then for Chiron, restore the heroic spirit. It has been the dearth of actual heroism that has been one of the contributing factors to the world getting in the state that it's in. And of course, if you want to see more heroism in the world, you begin by transforming yourself. And that's exactly what Chiron can help us do. Now for the moon, a new moon. And so, of course, that means it's time for renewal. For the Scorpio moon, the do's are focus, go deep, examine motivations, and the don'ts are forming new acquaintances, family gatherings, and manipulations. So just bear all those things in mind. Tread carefully if you are introduced to someone new, and tread very carefully if you are getting together with that family tonight. I would say avoid controversial subjects today. Not the time. So November begins with the new moon and a chance to look deeply within and ask the big questions. But far from this being a time to beat yourself up, the Sagittarian Venus creates a cozy atmosphere of good spirits and benevolence. Don't be afraid to seek clarity. It's not going to be as bad as you think to rip off the initial Band-Aid. So I hope that gives anyone who might be looking deeper within a little bit more confidence about, it's a whatever you discover, it's not there to hurt you or to reopen new wounds. It's about understanding. It's about figuring out a way forward. Now, for today's tarot card, we have the Tower. Very dramatic. You might think, but I thought there was going to be some gentle stuff today. Well, yes, there is, but it's also about renewal. And sometimes in order to renew, something has to topple down. And that's exactly why the Tower did pop up for us today. It's, of course, a major arcana card, which means just expansive impact. It's going to be a big one. Its number in the major arcana is 16, so you break that down with 1 plus 6, that equals 7, and that brings us to representing the idea of illusions and breakthroughs. And the key words for the card itself are repression, breaking the mold, questioning convention. This is about renewal. This is about making that new year new. And this is about making you new. You do not have to feel stuck. You do not have to be one-dimensional. You do not have to be defined by anything in your past or what other people think of you. You can look at things for yourself and you can decide, is this good for me? Is this bad for me? Is this making me better? Is this making me worse? And for the Tower falling, it's an opportunity to really re-examine that whole paradigm, question your premises, go back to the beginning, and try to look at everything with much more open eyes. So don't fear the crash and the tumble of the Tower. Just see it as an opportunity to see how the lay of the land looks once it does, and to decide what you're going to do with it, because this really is an opportunity and a blessing in disguise. Today's Celtic triad reads, three martyrdoms without slaying, the liberality of a needy person, the innocence of a young person, and fair maintenance without wealth. These are things that'll kill you without actually killing you. Poor financial management, it leads to an endless cycle of poverty, as so many people can attest to. The lack of life experience, however natural and understandable, it does make young people vulnerable by definition, and they absolutely cannot help it. And sometimes it does create significant problems in their lives, which is why you need to have an older generation who's mature and actually has advice worth listening to. So that's a pretty strong counsel for those of us who are getting older. We need to be worthy of offering advice because if the kids have no one to look up to and we aren't worthy of being looking up to, we are perpetuating the problems that their innocence brings them. And then living beyond your means, that creates misery, it creates stress, it gives you early gray hair, it just makes life much more difficult. And I don't know why those cats are yelling. I'll have to see to that after this video. Anyway, but this is all about being careful about putting ourselves into needlessly difficult positions and just being aware that, it might not seem like as big of a deal at first, but it grows over time. And the next thing you know, you just feel like your whole life is being sucked out of you. So it's an opportunity to be careful. And now, welcome to a slight little tweak I've made to our daily forecast. For some while, I've been doing correspondences. You had a color of the day, you had a plant of the day, you had an animal of the day, you had a crystal of the day, and it all centered around a particular theme. And if you enjoy doing that, please don't let me stop you from doing that independently. But I decided for the channel, what I wanted to do, at least for a little while, is focus all the correspondences that I bring up that relate to the overall feeling of the month. And for November, it's all about thankfulness, gratitude, agriculture, the domestic sphere, ultimately Thanksgiving at the end of the month. It's about family, it's about friends, it's about communal connectivity, and also our connectivity with the earth and with the gods. And so all the correspondences this month will relate to that theme. And the first one we have are gnomes, adorable little gnomes. They are earth elementals. They're associated with the colors of green and brown, for tarot, the suit of pentacles. And they have powers over agriculture, balance, confidence, consciousness, dream work, endurance, fertility, grounding, imagination, inspiration, knowledge, prosperity, secrets, and skills. So I would encourage you to do some further research on gnomes and just see what you can learn about them. Next up, today's practices. We're also changing up a little bit. You know, I still have a few bullet points for you to consider, but I'm also bringing you a quote each day, and it has to do with essentially household management, whether it's coming at it from a mundane or magical perspective. So our first quote comes from the book Kitchen Witchery by Lisa Chamberlain. She writes, "It can be argued that the discovery of fire, how to create it and harness its power, was the beginning of full-fledged magical practice for our earliest ancestors." How true that is, because fire is the element of transformation. It's also the fire of drive, that application of will and and imposing that will to ensure that the outcome is in conformity with our desires. That is magic. That is learning how to do magic. And fire plays a very big role in that. And of course, with fire in its relationship to the household, it comes down to heating. It comes down to cooking. It comes down just to having the comfort of a glow in the fireplace at the end of an evening, whether it is real wood or it's gas logs or, you know, any other kind of arrangement. It's all about that moment of transformation and having it among us. And then we have some Thanksgiving trivia. 2024 is the 100th anniversary of Macy's Thanksgiving Day Parade. So I thought that was interesting. I think this is a good moment for us to pick up a few autumnal hobbies. You know, the weather's going to be getting cold. We're going to be spending more time inside. We should probably be doing more with our time than just, you know, being in front of the screens and consuming things. You know, picking up hobbies, whether, you know, maybe you're doing woodworking, maybe you're doing some kind of needlecraft, whatever your hobby is, definitely reinfuse some interest into it. You might consider carrying rose quartz today and also have a cozy evening in. And what is your favorite way to spend a late autumn evening in? Because this is amongst my favorite times of year. I love being able to stay in. I love seeing that sunset early in the evening. Just seeing the colors fade into the darkness of the night. I love having those ambiences of the fireplaces or a little autumnal witchy scenes. It makes me feel cozy. I like sharing a cup of cocoa with husband unit of an evening. I like just blocking out the entire rest of the world, paying attention to him, and whatever it is that we're talking about. It's nice. It's about having that reconnection. And there's something about autumn that always reinvigorates that connection for us. So what does that for you? And now for today's journal prompt. What makes you grateful for that special person who is the love of your life? And I found it's a rather lovely romantic picture for us to contemplate as we to give this idea some consideration. And of course, if you're single or if you have not met that love of your life, you might do this as an opportunity to, you know, what qualities are you really looking for? What do you think you would be drawn for? What do you think are the personality characteristics that would be a balance of your own energies? That would be something that you could really see yourself working in partnership with over the long haul. So definitely well worth contemplating all of that. So on that note, my dears, have a magical day. I will see you guys in the next one. And of course, be sure to leave your lovely comments for me in the comment section below. But bye for now.